Over the last few days, I've been playing around with macros in UGS, Universal G-Code Sender. I've been trying to get the software to calculate tool height difference between tool changes. So I often use different materials, sometimes in a vise, sometimes straight on the spore board. And I wanted an easy way to calculate the tool height difference between different operations using different tools. So I got hold of one of these cheap Amazon tool setters. I've got that wired into the probe, and it's also got an over travel sensor as well, which is wired into the e-stop, just in case. And you can see I've had a few crashes already. Let's get into it. So we've got our Stream Deck here, which is controlling pretty much everything through UGS via hotkeys. So we've got sort of axis jogging, we can zero different axes, run, start jobs, return to home, all that good stuff. And then we can also do tool changes, tool setting, and all that good stuff. The way this macro is working is it's using a spare work coordinate system, and in this case it's using G59. I very rarely use any more than G54 and G55. So as long as you have one spare work coordinate system, this should work just fine. So I'm just going to mount some material. Okay, so we're going to home the machine. Great, machine is now home, so we're going to use the tool change position, which is a front center position that I've set up just on a macro. We're going to start with a 12mm 3 flute. Okay, so the first thing we do with the macro is we actually use the macro before we set any zeros. So I've just got that set up on. It's lifted the head and it's popped us back into G54 work coordinates. So now we're gonna drop over to our work zero. So we're just scratching off there on our work coordinates. So we're in G54, we've put the head where we want it, and we're going to zero out X, Y, and Z. So now we're all zeroed out on X, Y, and Z. We could run the job until it gets to a tool change. So let's simulate that. So we're going to come back and change the tool. We're going to use two tools which are completely different lengths. We've loaded up our next tool. So the first thing we're going to do is run the tool setter again. So we've run the tool setter, and now we're just going to return to G54. So we're going to do one more tool change. So we'll just hit tool change macro. Now we're swapping to a 1/4-inch single flute. And first thing we do again is tool setter. now we can send the tool back to G54000. Hang on. Well, I hope that helped. If you want to use a tool setter with Universal G-Code Sender, I can't take all the credit though. I had lots of help from Myles at New Tech, as well as Pete at Root CNC. If you want to know more about this CNC, about how I designed it, put it together, do drop me a comment and I'll be sure to make some more videos.